There are many questions in life so mysterious that it's difficult to imagine a clear and easy answer. What is outside the universe? How was Stonehenge built? Have we hosted extraterrestrial visitors? What does it all mean? What is life about? And what is going on with the Carolina squat? Today, we'll be discussing this unique and strange style, and we'll talk about how it came to be. So first of all, what is it? Well, the Carolina squat refers to a style usually put on trucks or SUVs of lifting the front end of your vehicle and lowering the back end of your vehicle. This creates a look where the nose of the vehicle sticks up and the rear of the vehicle, well, squats. So a very viable question that you may be asking yourself right now is, well, why? We'll get there. But first, with a name like Carolina squat, where do you think this style originated from? If you said California, you're right. Actually originated in Baja racing in California. It actually was a practical suspension adjustment for that Baja racing purpose. The famous off-road racing circuit course Baja has desert and hilly terrain, resulting in some awesome whipping sands, big jumps, and general excitement. The whole idea of the Carolina squat was designed to be able to hit a jump at high speed and without landing directly on the vehicle's nose. You know, it's designed to land flat so it doesn't crash. So, is there any practical purpose outside of off-road Baja racing? No! Maximum cargo weight of the bed is greatly reduced. Aerodynamics are greatly negatively affected. Maybe more dangerously, vision over the front hood of the vehicle becomes greatly diminished. It helps, of course, the approach angle of the vehicle, but greatly decreases ground clearance due to the lowered rear. It wears out suspension components more quickly. It creates a situation where headlights actually point up higher, so they're not pointing at the road, a road that you might not be able to see anyway due to the lifted nose, but also you might be blinding oncoming traffic. Basically, if you see a vehicle like this, unless it's a non-daily driver almost exclusively used to race off-road, it is intended simply for style. So how is it a trend sweeping across the country, and why is it called the Carolina squat? Well, like everything in life, we can blame that on social media. Awkward as that's what I do for a living. People taking pictures on Instagram posted up in front of their off-road style trucks led to the style being popularized and gain national circulation. It particularly caught on in the South, notably in Louisiana, Georgia, and in North and South Carolina. Not only did that contribute to the name, but also the Carolina squat can also refer to a different activity. The activity of revving one's engine to redline in a squatted truck with a bed full of people bouncing their hands in the air. And that activity was also called the Carolina squat. So the name kind of gave rise to the style as a whole being referred to as that title. It's also called the Californian lean, the Tennessee lean, or just the truck squat. It's also popular in the Dakotas, which is worth noting. I want to call it the Dakota duck. In many places, due to the demand for suspension components of this style, manufacturers started having to shelve units specifically for this unique style. An easy way to do this is simply install the front half of a lift kit on your vehicle. Or the full way of doing this is, of course, to install that front half lift kit on your vehicle, but also using a ball joint lift or adjusted torsion bar for the rear. Some owners just remove the rear blocks or drop shackles as well. So let me say, as much as we're poking fun, it's not up to us to tell anyone what they're supposed to do with their own vehicle. Respect all mods, respect all builds and whatnot, but I will say the safety and visibility concerns are a little worrying. So that brings us up to date on the Carolina squat. I want to thank you so much for watching. My name is Mitchell. I'm sitting here at Fred Haas Toyota Country, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks a lot.